Good morning to all of our viewers who join us on the internet and on Facebook on this Tuesday within the fifth week of Lent. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of God our Father, His Son, the Lord Jesus, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. My brothers and sisters, gathering once again as the family of God, we celebrate the dying and the rising of Christ to new life. To enter deeply into this saving mystery, we call to mind our sins. And during this season of repentance, we ask the Father for his forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you are the suffering servant of God.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you were raised high on the cross, pierced for our sins.
Christ,
suffering servant, forgive our sins.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive all our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, perseverance in obeying your will, that in our days the people dedicated to your service may grow in both merit and number. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and who reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the book of Numbers. From Mount Hor, the children of Israel set out on the Red Sea road to bypass the land of Edom. But with their patience worn out by the journey, the people complained against God and Moses. Why have you brought us up from Egypt to die in this desert where there is no food or water? We are disgusted with this wretched food. In punishment, the Lord sent among the people seraph serpents, which bit the people so that many of them died. Then the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned in complaining against the Lord and you. Pray the Lord, take the serpents away from us." So Moses prayed for the people, and the Lord said to Moses, "Make a seraph and mount it on a pole, and whoever looks at it after being bitten will live." Moses accordingly made a bronze serpent and mounted it on a pole. And whenever anyone who had been bitten by a serpent looked at the bronze serpent, he lived. The word of the Lord. O Lord, hear my prayer, and let my cry come to you. O Lord, hear my prayer, and let my cry come to you. O Lord, hear my prayer, and let my cry come to you. Hide not your face from me in the day of my distress. Incline your ear to me in the day when I call. Answer me speedily. O Lord, hear my prayer, and let my cry come to you. The nations shall revere your name, O Lord, and all the kings of the earth your glory. When the Lord has rebuilt Zion and appeared in his glory, when he has regarded the prayer of the destitute and not despised their prayer. O Lord, hear my prayer, and let my cry come to you. Let this be written for the generation to come, and let his future creatures praise the Lord. The Lord looked down from his holy height. From heaven he beheld the earth, to hear the groaning of prisoners, to release those doomed to die. O Lord, hear my prayer, and let my cry come to you. So the people said, is he not going to kill himself, is he? Because he said, where I am going, you cannot come. Jesus said to them, you belong to what is below. I belong to what is above. You belong to this world, but I do not belong to this world. That is why I told you that you will die in your sins. For if you do not believe that I am, you will die in your sins. So they said to Jesus, who are you? Jesus said to them, what I told you from the beginning, I have much to say about you in condemnation, but the one who sent me is true. And what I heard from him, I now tell the world. They did not realize that he was speaking to them of the Father. So Jesus said to them, when you lift up the Son of Man, then you will realize I am, and that I do nothing on my own, but I say only what the Father has taught me. The one who sent me is with me. He has not left me alone, because I always do what is pleasing to him. Because Jesus spoke this way, many came to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
By the words of the Gospel, may our sins be wiped away. Once again, a very warm welcome to those who have entered our electronic church, our electronic cathedral, by means of this wonderful technology. We are always very grateful to those who help stream this live Mass, especially David Santiago, who is here faithfully every morning live streaming the Mass. Our organist and soloist, Marion Scott, providing beautiful music for this Tuesday of the fifth week of Lent. Brothers and sisters, perhaps the greatest revelation of God, apart from the incarnation of his Son Jesus, the greatest revelation of God was when he revealed is named Moses. We know the story well. Moses approaches the burning bush, and God tells him to remove your sandals because the ground you stand on is holy. And as Moses prostrated himself before the burning bush, God tells him, I have heard the cry of my people. I know what they are suffering. Go to Pharaoh and tell him to let my people go. But Moses entreats God further, and he says, but what is your name? Whom shall I say sends me? And then that great moment of revelation. I am who am. Tell Pharaoh, I am, has sent me to you. The revelation of God's name, the greatest event in all of human history. Because brothers and sisters, when we know a person's name, we have a certain power over them. David, come here. John, come here. Mary, do this. We have a certain power over them. When God revealed his name to Moses, he gave us power over him. A wonderful manifestation of God coming to his people. And centuries later, a feast we celebrated last week in the Annunciation, when Gabriel announced to Mary that she would give birth to the Savior of the world, that the second person of the Most Blessed Trinity would enter her womb. That was God's Word made flesh. And throughout his life, Jesus would use that phrase, I am. And it was more than just a part of the verb to be. What Jesus is doing is using the very name God revealed to Moses on the heights of Mount Sinai. And in this morning's gospel, it comes loud and clear. He is just days before his passion and death. And Jesus would use a symbol that was very familiar to his people. We read it in the first reading. They were disgusted with the food God had sent in the desert. And because of their disobedience, serpent snakes were biting people. And when they implored Moses to ask God to remove it, God told Moses to construct a seraph serpent, a bronze serpent, having all the appearances of a deadly serpent without the venom. And when people looked at this serpent, they were cured of their malady, of their illness. Jesus uses that symbol for himself. He said, when they will raise me up, I will draw all things to myself. Just as Moses lifted up that serpent, so will I be lifted up. Jesus would have the appearance of a criminal, but he would not be. He lacked that venom. So a very apt imagery Jesus is bringing us this morning, these days right before Holy Week, as we come closer and closer to the mystery of the Lord's cross. And again, the rest of this week and next week, Jesus will constantly tell the people, I am, I am. Truly, a God who loves us so much that he would go to the cross for us. So brothers and sisters, during these days of hunkering down, these days when we are alone, many of us, social distancing, We look to Jesus for that strength and encouragement. We follow Jesus these holy days of Lent, and we walk with him that way of the cross. And we pray on this fifth Tuesday in Lent that we will prepare well for the coming holy days of Holy Week, joining our Lord in the agony of his cross. A God who so loves us, who so cares for us, he would endure the agony of the cross. What love Jesus shows us. So here at Our Lady of the Holy Rosary, St. Richard, we wish all of you a day filled with that love of God. May he be blessed forever. God be with you this day. Let us now, brothers and sisters, lift our hearts and minds to God as we present our petitions. That the Church of God may continue to be purified and sanctified during the season of repentance, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We continue to pray for our president, the governor of our state, the mayor of our city, that they may lead us through the empowerment of the Holy Spirit in the ways of justice and of service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who have turned from God, those who are desperate, those who are alone, those who suffer from addiction or depression, that they may receive the grace of conversion from God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That this Lenten season may be a time of growing in the gifts God has given us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for all of us, during this time of the coronavirus, we pray that God will assist each of us, those of us diagnosed with the coronavirus, the caregivers, the doctors, the nurses, the first responders, those who put their own lives on the front lines, that Jesus may help them with his grace and his healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for our beloved dead, that this Lenten season be a time of grace for them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord our God, hear and graciously accept the prayers we offer you this day, and we make them in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
Oh,
that my sacrifice and yours become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. We offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation, that being moved to compassion, you may pardon our offenses and direct our wavering hearts. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty. Since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment of the world is now revealed and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Father, with all of the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we now acclaim. And entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with Thomas, our Archbishop, together with all of the clergy, the religious, for all men and women who serve the church. Father, remember Betty and Desmond Cosier. Remember Carl St. Clair Rattigan, whom you have now called from this life. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Most Holy Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with all of the saints, with our holy Trinitarian founders, St. John Damatha, St. Felix of Venema, together with the Holy Bishop St. Richard, and all who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. For it is through Christ, with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory, all honor be yours forever and ever. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, Father, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Brothers and sisters, may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And your spirit.
Thank you.
this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us, receive it. Lord Jesus Christ, with faith in your love and mercy, I eat your body and I drink your blood. Let it not bring me condemnation, but health in mind and in body. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold the suffering servant. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Corpus Domini nosti Jesu Christi, custodiet anima meum, vita me eterna. Amen. Sanctus Domini, nostri Jesu Christi, custodiet anima mea, vita eterna. I now invite those of our brothers and sisters joining us by the internet to make a spiritual act of communion, asking the Lord Jesus, even though we are not able to physically receive his body and blood, but to come into our hearts and souls, to give us every grace and blessing. Come, Lord Jesus, into my heart and into my soul. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that ever seeking what is divine, we may always be worthy to approach these heavenly gifts. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. We bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. O God, who chose to show mercy, not anger, into those who hope in you, grant that your faithful may weep, as they should, for the evil we have done, and so merit the grace of your consolation, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, descend upon you, remain with you now and forever. Amen. The Mass is ended. We go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Once again, God bless you wonderful people for joining us in our electronic cathedral. We thank you again for participating in this Holy Mass. Again, Mass every day from today and through Saturday at 8 a.m. As we come closer to the end of the week, we will announce the schedule for Palm Sunday and the Holy Week observances, the holiest week of the year. May God be with you and your families. God love you.